Our next presenter is Koushik Sampath, College of Food, Agricultural and Natural Resource Sciences, Department of Bioproducts and Biosystems Science, Engineering and Management. Thank you.
Ever look back at your wasted attempt at high school to ask somebody out to prom and think you could have done a better job? Well, that's exactly how the paper industry feels about the amount of energy it uses to dry its wet sheets of paper. Obviously, there's a better way to do it. And mind you, paper is one of the most commonly used commodities in our daily lives, all the way from toilet paper to cardboard and printing paper. According to the Department of Energy, this $100 billion industry uses twice as much as energy used to power every single home in the United States. And currently, the industrial technology involves using a hot surface and hot air blowing over the surface to dry its wet sheets. Kind of like a silly way to use our kitchen hot plate and our hair dryer to make pancakes. This tech dates back to the early 18th century, so obviously the state of the art in today's world, am I right? Well, if you're 300 years old. With our friendly neighborhood COVID-19 coming into our lives, a lot of things have changed. Businesses have moved online, the use of printing paper is reduced, and the use of thicker forms of paper, like cardboard, that require 5 to 10 times more energy are more in use. This would translate to the amount of energy being used by this industry to go up from powering twice the number of homes in the United States to about 4 to 5 times, and all in just a decade. And adding to this huge burden of an energy crisis is our everlasting desire to produce more babies and increase our population. How do we tackle this mess, the burden of an energy crisis, and the need to sustain the next generation? This is where my research kicks in. We use sound, radio signals, and microwaves to save the day. Sound like Buttercup from the Powerpuff Girls screaming at the bad guys? More like me screaming at my paper samples to dry faster so I can get my PhD. And how is my radio or my cell phone going to help me dry my sheets faster? We all know how microwaves work. Turns out using sound, radio signals, and microwaves in a very concentrated spot is more efficient and effective to dry the samples more than the current industrial technology. And with this modified tech, we project a 30 to 50% improvement in the amount of energy, time, and costs involved in the whole process. And our initial results do complement these goals with as high as a 60% improvement. This is what I'd like to call the Gen Z of engineering, because if this isn't, I don't know what else is, my friends. While all of this sounds nice and fancy, it comes with a huge catch. Ever put a metallic spoon in your microwave to create your own little lightning? Well, imagine the size and intensity of this lightning when it happens at a 30-foot section of an equipment at the lab or at the industry, where the drying section is as long as a football field. Am I making a weapon of mass destruction, a new weapon to be used at the war? Although the chances of that happening are as low as messing up a 2 times 2 equals 4, but on the other hand, am I revolutionizing the paper industry to rethink its prom situation, cut down on its energy usage, and saving the world one industry at a time? Stay tuned to find out more. Thank you.